Hello, my name's Craig Earl, I'm market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to our daily market update. Today we've had a bright start in the markets following the release of the French industrial output figure, which came out showing a drop of only 0.1% despite expectations of a drop of 0.3%. And we have seen a positive reaction to this so far in the markets this morning. However, it's unlikely to have too big an impact on that fourth quarter GDP figure that we are going to see on Friday. We're still expecting the French GDP to contract by 0.2% in the fourth quarter. And one thing we're going to be looking for here is a potential revision to that third quarter GDP figure. Now that showed growth of 0.1% previously, and if we do see a downward revision here, then there is the potential for the French economy to actually fall into recession in the fourth quarter of last year. Like I say though, we have seen a positive reaction so far to this data this morning, and I think this is mainly down to a few things really. I think it's pretty light on the economic calendar this week. There's not too many major economic releases, so we are going to see smaller things like this starting to have an impact, and I think the lower volumes as well is going to contribute to this. So smaller impact news is probably going to have a bit of a bigger impact this week. And also we've got the fact that the corporate earnings season is starting to wind up now, so we've only got a few major companies reporting, including Coca-Cola and Fidelity tomorrow, Cisco on Wednesday, PepsiCo on Thursday, and then finally Kraft Foods on Friday. But compared to the corporate earnings calendar we have seen over the past month or so, this is very, very light. I think this week as well, there's going to be a lot more attention drawn to the Italian elections in a couple of weeks' time. Now, we saw that negative reaction last Monday to the polls over the weekend, which showed Silvio Berlusconi's PDL party actually gathered significant support in the polls, bringing it back to within 4 points of the leading Democratic Party. Now, these were originally not really seen as too much of a threat to the Democratic Party in these elections. There was concern that they may cause a bit of disruption following the elections if they get a certain number of seats in the upper house of Parliament, making it difficult for the Democratic Party to pass legislation in order to continue the reforms and the austerity plan that Mario Monti's already put in place. But now the fact that they've closed the lead to within the margin of error, there is actually now a potential for Silvio Berlusconi's PDL party to actually win the election. So I expect to see a lot more uncertainty surrounding this over the next couple of weeks. The political uncertainty, I think, is actually going to drive the markets lower. And given the fact that we have got stock markets currently significantly overbought, people are going to, I think, use this as an excuse to close out their positions, which means we could see a reduction of even up to 10% in the equity markets over the next month or so. Also, I think there's going to be a lot more attention on the US sequester. Now, that comes into play on the 1st of March, and there's a lot of confusion surrounding this at the moment, because we've had politicians from both sides saying that they don't want this sequester to come into play. They'd rather come to another deal on it, and yet this is something that they put together themselves only a year and a half ago. So this may be due to the fact that this was just set up, put in place to force force Congress to come to some form of spending cuts originally at the end of December, but now on the 1st, before the 1st of March. But there's still likely to be a lot of uncertainty leading up to then, given the fact that we have had some comments from both sides suggesting that unless they get some form of compromise, then they are willing to let this sequester come into play on the 1st of March, which is going to significantly have a significant negative impact on US growth. Finally, today we've got the Eurogroup meeting. Now, we're not expecting too much to come from this. A few different topics on the agenda are likely to be the bailout for Cyprus, which is likely to be discussed, but we're not likely to see anything materialise from this for the next few months. But there is a few key sticking points here, in particular the money laundering surrounding the Cypriotic banks, which is likely to be a key talking point. And there's also the fact, but usually we wouldn't see too much focus on this usually, but given the fact that we have got a huge exposure to Cyprus in Greece, which is very fragile at the moment, they've only just secured their own bailout, I think that we are going to see a lot more focus on this over the next few months. But like I said, I think there's going to be a long line of negotiations before we actually see a deal. Finally on the agenda at the Eurogroup meeting is going to be this euro strength. Again, we've seen a lot of calls from France, in particular François Hollande, to try and reduce the strength of the euro currency. Now, this has so far fallen on deaf ears from the northern members of the currency union, due to the fact that they can take the stronger euro much more easily than, say, France and its euro southern members. But I think there's going to be a lot more discussions of this over the next couple of months. I think this is going to be one of the key discussions today at the Eurogroup meeting, and then again at the G20 meeting later on in the week, which kicks off on Friday, when one of the topics on the agenda is going to be this currency wars, which has been so widely talked about over the next few weeks. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom, which can be found at www.alpari.co.uk/newsroom. And you can also follow us on Twitter. My username is Craig_AlpariUK. And then there's the Alpari Twitter feed as well. That's AlpariUKForex. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Craig Earlham, market analyst at Alpari UK.